Okay, in this video we are going to look at the top 5 updates and a bonus tool that we've just released in the Astute Graphics plugins. This first one is to do with menus. Now previously, if you'd used Astute Graphics plugins, you'll go over to the window menu and you'll find that they'll be listed throughout here in alphabetical order. We've changed that now. You can now go to Astute Graphics and there's a flyout menu with just our plugins, so you can either pick the ones you want and dock them, or you can show all, they'll all be displayed on the workspace and then you can dock them yourself. We've also changed the same up here. When you come up to Illustrator, you've now got a subsection here, so you've got about Astute Graphics plugins and then a side menu here. It used to be listed, but now we've just simplified it for you. So that's the first update. Let's move on to the second one. The second update is for Astute Buddy. Now, if you've been using the plugins, you'll know that we recently added Astute Buddy. It's our shortcut panel. It looks like this. And when we come over to one of the tools that uses it, say the Super Marquee tool, as soon as we start to select something, the shortcuts will be displayed in the Astute Buddy panel. And sometimes people didn't want that constantly open and didn't want to keep opening it when they wanted to use it. So, based on that feedback, we've made some changes. So, let's come back up to the selection tool. If we come into the preferences here, we can now decide whether we want the panel to automatically show when an Astute tool that uses shortcuts is selected and also hide it when it's deselected. So if we just click OK with them both selected, we'll just close that off there. I'll come back up to the tool here, and as soon as I've selected the tool, Astute Buddy will open up. As soon as I go to a tool that doesn't need it, it will close. And like I said, that's changeable in the preferences. You ask for it. We've delivered it. This next update is for InkFlow, which was one of our newer tools. Now with InkFlow you can start drawing, but something that was missing was the ability to continue to draw the path. So for instance, I've drawn an S here, it's a simple path, but say I just wanted to add a flourish, but I didn't want to use VectorScribe. So if we come over to VectorScribe, we can do extend path tool, but I want something more organic. So what we've done to InkFlow is we've added that ability. If I just come to the tool, I come over to the path and you can see there's like a double zero infinity shape. That means it's a connector. If I continue drawing, it's going to allow me to continue on that path. So if I just pull that out and do a nice flourish there, and I come down to the end here, you can see again, I've also got the same and I can continue that and pull that flourish in there, and it continues drawing along that path. And I can do the same for this one here, just to show you another example. We come back to the InkFlow tool, I can just come to the end here and I can pull that up and do a small flourish, and I can continue there and pull one round and add another extension to that path there. Now one other feature we've added is the ability to close or complete a path automatically based on a tolerance. So let's just have a look and see what that preference is. If we just open the preferences here, come down to InkFlow preferences, and we can see that we've got close path when ends are within, and I've got a tolerance of 15 pixels which I can change. And what that's going to do is tell InkFlow that when I get to a certain point I want that path to close. So let's just get rid of this artwork here. Let's come over to the pen, and all I'm going to do is draw a simple shape. I'm just going to pull that round and just watch the cursor, watch the InkFlow cursor. As I come back round to the end, you're going to see that connector path appear again. And that's because I'm now within 15 pixels of the start of the path. And it's just going to say to InkFlow, release and complete and close that path up. So depending on what we're drawing, we can set that tolerance. And if you want something that needs to be a closed path, you can go ahead and do it. Let's have a look at it working on this shape over here. So what I'm going to do is continue this path and come around and join it here. So I'm just going to make that a little bit thinner so we can see what we're doing. So I'm just going to continue drawing around this one here. I'm just going to come around to that shape and come over the top. And as you see, as I close in, the connector is going to show. And what it's going to do is just completely close that path up. So that's something that our users asked for. And we've added it to InkFlow. So that's two new features in InkFlow for you. Okay, this next update is to do with Vector First Aid and grouping. Now, quite often in artwork, when you've been handed it, you've got lots of groups and you may not want the artwork grouped like the originator created it. So one of the things you probably need to do is go through and manually ungroup everything, but we've added this feature to Vector First Aid. Now it comes with a caveat because sometimes there may be some effects that you don't want to lose. So we've added a warning. So if we take our artwork here, this guy on the scooter, let's just select all the artwork so we can see it highlighted in the layers panel. And you can see we've got some groups here. Now some of these are unnecessary groups, and if we did a check selection, we'd probably find some groups that don't even need to be there. But what we're going to do is show you this new feature. And this is completely ungroup. So what we're going to do is go ahead and click it, and I'm going to get a warning. It's going to say to me, do I want to include clipping groups, clipping paths, and warn me if group effects will be lost. So let's show both options. I'm going to click OK, and it's going to tell me that there are effects in this artwork, and I can skip them or ungroup them anyway. So let's skip them so that we can see some of the groups will be left behind and some of the groups with effects will be left as groups. So we'll skip. So I know that down here on his trousers, there's an effect. If we come over to the group and we just look inside, we'll just click that path there. We'll come over to the appearance panel and I can see that I've got a phantasm and hue saturation applied to it. So it's left that alone. Let's just Command Z and leave everything back in the groups again. And this time I'm going to ignore it and I'm going to say completely ungroup. I'm going to say to warn if it's going to happen, but I'm going to say ungroup them anyway. And you can see the artwork changed. I had some effects applied. Because I've ungrouped it, we've also lost the effects, and therefore the artwork has changed its appearance. So that's an extra thing we've added for Vector First Aid to help you out with large grouped pieces of artwork that you want to completely ungroup or tidy up. This next update for PathScribe is something that was also requested, and it's quite a simple one. We're just going to look at these paths here. So I've got four paths completely the same. And what I want to do is actually join the end of this one to the end of this one. All we need to do now is we come over to this path and select the end point there. And we'll come and select the second one holding the shift key. So I've got these two selected. What I want to do is join them. I'm just going to go to the flyout of PathScribe and I'm going to say connect paths. And what it's going to do is connect them, but with this properly mathematical smooth curve. So we just add that to the two paths and look how smooth that is and the minimal amount of points. So if we go ahead and click the rest of the points here, we can do the same for that. Connect paths, and we can do the same for these last two as well. Connect paths. And just look how nice and tidy that is. Very few points on there and a nice clean connection of all those paths together. You asked for it, we delivered it. Okay, this last tool is a bonus addition and it's something that's already in Dynamic Sketch, but we've decided to make it a standalone tool and it's called AG Trim and Join. It comes with preferences and we've got a couple of videos on YouTube that show you how to use these. We're just going to click OK at the moment and we're going to ask it to auto join paths after trimming. Click OK, come over to the tool, and without the artwork even being selected, all we need to do is just start trimming the artwork and it will know exactly where you want to cut. You tell it to slice it, you tell it to trim and join, and that's what it's exactly going to do. Multiple paths at the same time, and you can just keep going and trimming until you've decided that you've got exactly what you want. And that's it. That's the new AG Trim and Join. If you want to see more videos about that to see how to use it, like I said, just visit our YouTube channel where you can find videos of all of our tools, including all the new updates.